apostles gathered around Jesus and told him all that they had done and taught. And he said to them, come away to a deserted place, all by yourselves, and rest a while. For many were coming and going, and they had no leisure even to eat. And they went away in a boat to a deserted place by themselves. Now many saw them going and recognized them, and they hurried there on foot from all the towns and arrived ahead of them. As he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd. He began to teach them many things. And when they had crossed over, they came to a land in Gennesaret and moored the boat. When they got out of the boat, people at once recognized him and rushed about the whole region and began to bring the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he went, into villages or cities or farms, they laid the sick in the marketplaces, begged him that they might touch even the fringe of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Now, There is an Old Testament saying to the people of Israel, without a vision, the people perish. Because there has to be something to hope for. And that vision has to be put out in front of the people so that it has a sense of eternal promise to it. But look at the words of this hymn that you're going to sing in just a few moments. Be thou my vision, Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me save what you are and what thou art. I don't need anything else but who you are. Thou my best thought, by day and by night, walking or sleeping, thy presence, my life. Verse 4. Light in my soul, after victory won, may I reach heaven's joys, O heavenly Son. Heart of my own heart, whatever be false, you be my vision, O ruler of all. And this is the desert place that Jesus was calling his disciples to. Not just to sit there and say, boy, I'm tired, or I really needed this, but it is a moment in time to reflect upon yourself. There's a self-consciousness that we're called to say sooner or later, as the old saying goes, that the unexamined life probably isn't worth living. But the examined life also brings to it a certain introspection that defines who you are at any given moment. And sometimes we get so busy, even in doing good things, and our church does good things, I admit to that. But there has to be a moment in time where you just break away and simply say, I need to be alone right now. And I need to recoup. I need to redefine myself, what my core being is, what I'm called to do. I call myself Christian, but what does that really mean? Is that a question that any of us really ask that often? Or why do I take up time and space? Be philosophical about it. Why do I exist? Why am I breathing? Why are you sitting here breathing this morning? Right now, this is, even though I'm talking, a quiet place. Place where we reflect, where we want to say to ourselves, what is my vision? Not just my vision of myself, but what visions have I accumulated over the years as to who and what God is all about? Most certainly, the gospel this morning shows an active Jesus, one that gets very tired, one that once fell asleep in a storm on a boat, one who is so exhausted sometimes that he goes away in other parts of the gospel, even away from the disciples, and they don't know where he is, and he goes to what is called a lonely place to be alone and pray to his Father. These are the things that we're called to emulate. If we want to say that, oh, I follow Jesus, well, okay, you follow Jesus, and that's great. I mean, doing the things of recovery and helping people and reaching out, evangelism and outreach programs and all of those wonderful things, but at the same time, he says, you need to stop every once in a while, lest you start to think that this is all you are. And it's good to be an evangelist, and it's good to do outreach, but it isn't all that you are. When everything else is torn away, who are you really? Now, I see this every once in a while, and now and then when I go to a nursing home, I have to stop and think. I remember going to see this one woman. I didn't know who she was, but I was recommended that I go and see her. And as I walked into the room, it's a two-bedroom room. It's kind of in half, bed on either side. And on her side were the following things. A clock. Some pictures, three pictures, family pictures. A little map that she had crocheted that was on top of the bureau. And I sat down and I spent about an hour with her, and what did I discover? And this was, gosh, 30 years ago. She was a nurse in the Nurses Army Corps on Iwo Jima. And she saw terrible, terrible things and did her best to try to tend the wounded and even to try to cover the dead. And when she came home, she married, and she continued to be a nurse. She had four children. Her husband predeceased her. Two of her children predeceased her. And she retired as a nurse and did some volunteer work of teaching in inner city schools. And
now at 85, frail, lying in the bed, if you walked into that room, you would think the only thing that defined her was the mat that she crocheted, the three pictures, and the little baby bed with the alarm clock that had been in her life all her years. Can you reduce a person to just that? Or is there more to be said beyond even what we see? And if that's true in what we see in other people and how it comes into our lives, and we want to say, oh, no, no, there's more to you. I know you've been reduced to this in your old age. I get it. I understand it. But let's talk about what has happened and who you are and what defines you. And ultimately, when everything else is taken away, what do people have left that define them at any given moment? And so we talked about the fact that she was born a Baptist. And I said, do you remember when you were baptized? And she said, oh, you are never. She said, you know how it's done. Oh, yes, I do. I know how it's done. And the pastor held me and dunked me under the water, and I thought, oh, my God, he's going to drown me. But he didn't. And I said, I think your identity was made at that point of who you are. Because when everything else fails, when our jobs go away, the people we love go away, the things we used to do and can no longer do, the real question is, do you really still have an identity that reaches out into eternity? And of course that answer is yes. And so when we're invited to go out into those desert places and we say, all right, let me be quiet now. Let me just stop and think, what defines me? You all know, for example, that my wife is in dialysis. I know a lot of people that are in dialysis, and some live a long time and some don't. And so, although we know we're going into this correctly, there is that thing that cloud is over your head that says, like in most marriages, someone's going to leave before the other. And so I sat down the other day and I thought, what if this happens? What am I going to do? How do I handle this with my kids and my grandkids and so on? And I got a little overwhelmed with the thought of that scenario, so to speak. And I said, but the future is not going to always be defined by me, it will be defined by God. And in that definition, the reality is that who my wife is and who I am, ultimately, we are alone in our thoughts with God. And there are things that are never shared, even between husband and wives and lovers and partners, that define them internally. And when you go into that desert place, it can be sometimes scary. But I think over and again, as you heard in the anthem of the solo this morning by Sue, and also in the hymn that you're going to sing in about 2 minutes, is the reality of who we really are. And when you're alone, being able to say, be thou my vision, Lord of my heart. Not all is to me, save the Lord. You're my best thought, my day, my night, walking or sleeping. You're my presence and my light. And light up my soul after victory won. May I reach heaven's joys, O heavenly Son. Heart of my own heart, whatever befall, still be my vision. O you, ruler of all. Let us now stand and sing today's hymn of the day. Be thou my